Hello everyone and welcome back to Veluwe Zoo. It feels good to say that. You might have seen it. I've been gone for like 6 weeks, 7 weeks, 8 weeks maybe. I don't know. I only uploaded one video. That was the shell challenge because I told Savannah I would do that within the time frame. But yeah, we have been gone. We moved to our new house. We have been renovating. We have been moving. So I didn't have time to make any content. But we are back. We are back in Veluwe Zoo. And it feels good. I have to say that. I was a little bit burned out with the game. When I quit YouTube for like a few weeks. And I hoped when I would get back into the game, I would have a perfect plan for the aquatic area, and I didn't. Basically, that's the conclusion that we have here. So I decided to give someone the chance to make a building for Veluwe Zoo. So right now, someone is working on a new aquatic house, which is basically the back of the penguin habitat and on the side of the seal habitat and the others. We didn't put the dwarf caiman in yet. I hope it will be part of the new aquatic house, but we will see. And once I got that all planned out, I finally had motivation to get back into Veluwe Zoo. And what I did, I deleted the entire giant anteater area. So I deleted that habitat, I deleted that building. I think I mentioned this before in the videos. I didn't really like how it looked. We didn't create a habitat for the jaguar yet, so that's what we are doing today. So I deleted everything and I decided to make an entire new South America area, because that's still one of my favorite packs, and I think we didn't give it the attention it deserved in Veluwe Zoo. We only had the giant anteater, and we did put the capuchin monkeys into the monkey house in the beginning of Veluwe Zoo, or like in the front at the entrance. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put lemurs in that building, and we are gonna create a dedicated capuchin monkey habitat in this area as well. It's actually gonna be on the side of the little viewing area that we already created. But then I decided, first I have to finish up the jaguar habitat, and that's what we are doing today. Of course, I'm going in with the new rocks. I think the temple pieces and the new rocks, at least that what was I was thinking in the beginning, they would be a perfect match to create something really cool, and that's what we are doing today. So this is all going to be like a temple-ish vibe going on. We have a lot of rocks, we have a lot of foliage. I'm not going to put any foliage in mind of like realism, what could grow here, yes, no. I just want to create something beautiful. When it comes down to buildings and viewing areas, I do like to keep in mind some realism. You will see that with the building in the end. But right now I'm just a little bit of experimenting. I'm gonna cover up all the paths with like rocks and temple pieces. And this was all a bit of inspired by the shell challenge that I did. I love the rock work that I did there, and I would love to make something like that in Veluwe Zoo. So that's what we are doing with this one. The plans for Veluwe Zoo are, we are gonna finish up this area. So we're gonna do capuchin monkeys, jaguars, that's what we're doing today, or actually black panther, and then the giant anteater will be in this area. And we will leave the llamas for what it is. They already have a dedicated habitat, and we might add one, or maybe have one or two animals more. We will see. We will see what I can come up with. And we will do a tour video once the new aquatic house is finished. I'm really excited for that. And then we are finishing off Veluwe Zoo. It's a sad moment. I'm already planning a new project, of course. But sometimes things have to come to an end, and I think right now I will have like 10-15 frames left when I'm playing in Veluwe Zoo. So I think it's time to finish it off and start something new and start something better. You can really see the progress that we had during like the building of Veluwe Zoo. I think we got better in like building and realism, and the rock work got better, and I don't know. I think it's time to make something cool. So we are gonna do that. So we're gonna finish up some projects. I'm already building in the petting zoo while I'm yesterday evening while I'm recording this. And that's also a project that we are gonna finish. It's gonna be the final speed build on my channel, and then we will do a tour, probably a cinematic tour. I don't know. We will see. I still have to discuss this with Jure. But he knows that we are basically finishing off the project. Also, depending on a new DLC, maybe if we get a Padding Zoo DLC, we might get back into the project. But yeah, I have no clue yet what Frontier is up to. I did see a little database update yesterday, so something is coming up. That's really exciting. And of course, some news from Prehistoric Kingdom. That will also be a game that we will cover on this channel. So the alpha is going to be like in a few weeks, actually in 2 weeks, the alpha is going to start. I already had contact with the developers. I hope they didn't forget me, and I really hope that we will get some early access so we can cover the game on the channel. But yeah, if we don't, I will cover it anyway, but a little bit later. We will see. I really hope we can cover the game. I'm super excited about that one. It seems that it's gonna be the Jurassic World Evolution that we all hoped for. That's basically my idea. Like the possibilities that we have in Planet Zoo together with dinosaurs, that's what I'm hoping for, and I really hope that they can live up to those expectations. Of course, it's a smaller development team, so yeah, we just have to see what they come up with at the game. But the things that I've seen so far look really promising. So it's gonna be exciting times on the channel. I hope you guys are happy that we are back. Of course, we already did 2 live streams. If you were there, thank you. If you were not there, we are moving all the live streams back to YouTube. I think Twitch is a wonderful place, but I think we build a wonderful community on YouTube, and I think we have to connect to the community again. It felt more like I was streaming like in Discord with friends when I was streaming on Twitch. Sometimes someone new would pop in, but I missed a lot of you guys. I missed a lot of familiar names, and we are gonna continue the career mode whenever I have time. Of course, it will probably be in the weekend. I still work in a shift, so I work in the evening, so which makes it almost impossible for me to stream in the evening. And streaming in the morning, I think a lot of people are working, so right now I will dedicate my mornings to making videos, building something, and hopefully we can get back to a normal schedule. But streams will be probably like every weekend or once, well, I don't know, we will see, once every 2 weeks. We will see what we can come up with. I want to finish up that career mode because we also started that, and I started a lot, didn't finish a lot, so we are finishing up projects basically. That's what we are doing. As you can see, I talked a lot, and we also built a lot. We started on the building on the back. I did some theming on the front, and on the back it's just concrete, so I put in all the staff buildings. So this will be the staff area for the entire South America area. I planned it a little bit only in my head. I didn't draw anything, but I think I can connect all the habitats that I have in mind with these buildings. Keep in mind, this is still a franchise zoo. If you are following Veluwe Zoo and think it's sandbox, well, it's definitely not. So we have to keep in mind education, the guests, the animal welfare. So they need to like the plants that we put into the habitat. They need to have enough space. They need to have enough climbing space, all stuff like that, shelter space. It's all really important. So that's what we are creating over here. I'm experimenting a little bit with the roof, but finally I decided, yeah, I have to theme this part as well. So we will make a little, temple style area. I don't know, it looks cool. I've been working with these temple pieces a lot in Planet Coaster, actually. I've started a project, and of course didn't finish it in time. Why not? It's always the same with me. I started on a little contest, like a mini park contest, and I did like an Aztec roller coaster theme. I might finish it one day, and we'll do a little tour video on the channel if you guys are interested in that. I think Planet Coaster is a really cool game. I would love to cover it a little bit more on the channel, but I know it's also kind of an old game, so I'm not sure how many of you are interested in that, and we might put our energy in like Prehistoric Kingdom. And if you have any other game suggestions, let me know down in the comments. Maybe I've missed something. Maybe there's a game that is coming up and you're like super excited about it and you want me to play it and cover it on the channel, let me know down in the comments, and I will read every comment, of course. Again, I might have missed some in the past few months, weeks, and that's basically because I didn't actually look at the YouTube Studio app anymore. I just wanted to take some time off from that as well. We did reach 7,000 subscribers in the meantime. Although I wasn't uploading anything, you guys were still subscribing to the channel, and that's really cool. If you are here and not subscribed yet, make sure you do, so you won't miss out on anything new. And it it really motivates me to keep going, to see more and more people coming in. And I'm excited to be back. Actually, I got back into Planet Zoo this weekend, did two live streams, and it got me back into the game. I'm really excited, and I put a lot of time and effort into this game already in the last week or so. So I hope everything will go as planned. For example, the live streams, that was a headache because I was really hoping to get a good internet connection, because I still remember moving into the apartment. It took me like, I don't know, half a year to get a proper internet connection for me being able to play online games without being disconnected. And in this house, it was actually plug and play. That's insane. I hired an electrician actually to put wired connections all over the house, so we have some wired internet connection to the top floors, and I'm using that, so that's all good. But still, it's still tricky to get a proper internet connection to be able to live stream. But we dropped zero frames during the first live stream, so I'm really, really happy about that. I'm happy to be back up and running. So today we are going to finish up this Jaguar Habitat. I think it came out really well. I love the theming, and we needed a little bit of water, so that's what I'm putting in right now. It's a Jaguar, but I wanted to do the Black Panther thing, so I adopted two albino ones, and it cost me a lot of conservation credits, but I think it's really cool that they put that in the game, so I wanted to make a dedicated habitat for them. If you want to make me or you want me to make an actual jaguar habitat, let me know. We can maybe do something small, or I don't know, we will see. If you enjoyed the video, it will probably go on for a few more minutes. The speed build itself, I have to get used to back or like I have to get used to talking to myself again. It has been a while, so I'm gonna keep it short. 12 minutes, 30 minutes, actually, I did pretty well. Hopefully in the next episode we will have some gameplay again. I always like to record the gameplay, but sometimes I just forget and I just want to get back into it and just build. So that's why we have a speed build only today, but I will try to pop in some gameplay very soon. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure you hit the like button. If you aren't subscribed yet, consider doing so. It will help me out a lot, and you won't miss out on anything new in Veluwe and the new projects as well. And I will speak to you guys in the next one. Goodbye. Yoo-yoo.